Okay, when you're given a function, you can find the x and y intercepts, and I chose a quadratic function for a particular reason. We're used to linear functions probably, so quadratics can be a little more difficult, but not bad. In general, quadratic functions are called that because it's x squared instead of just x to the first power, like right here this is x to the first. So this is quadratic, and it has a shape if you graph it. It's an upward parabola or a downward parabola. So if you can imagine, if you were to graph that, you'd have one y-intercept here, and you could possibly have two x-intercepts even. So it's not like a line that has one of each, typically. So that's one reason I want to look at the quadratic to see what happens. So to find, for example, the y-intercepts, there's only one y-intercept every time, so that's pretty easy. To find the y-intercepts, x has to be 0. So you look at this function, and let me remind you that f of x is the same thing as y, so I'm going to change that to y, and I'm going to replace all the x's with 0. Well, 0 squared is 0, 5 times 0 is 0, plus 6 is 6. So if x is 0, y is 6, so x is 0, so the order pair is 0, comma, 6, because an order pair is x comma y. X is 0, y is 6, and you get one order pair for the y-intercept. So there's only one y-intercept. The x-intercept you find similarly, there may be multiple x-intercepts, and there may be none, actually. You set y equal to 0. Okay? So now I look at this equation, I replace y with 0, and now I have to solve for x. Well, this is a quadratic equation with 0 on one side already, so we need to factor the other side. So x plus 2 is 0, or x plus 3 is 0. So subtract 2, x has to be negative 2, or x has to be negative 3. So if x is, remember y was 0, and x is negative 2, so that's one order pair, negative 2 comma 0, x comma y, or, well sorry, not or, you've got two y-intercepts, or x-intercepts in this case, so negative 2, 0 is one of them, and negative 3, 0 is the other, because if x is negative 2, y is 0, and if x is negative 3, y is 0. So we have two x-intercepts.